Here we go, Micah chapter 3, verse 5 through 12. Thus says the Lord concerning the prophets who lead my people astray. Fair enough to say we've got good application here, right? We're not pulling something out of context. Thus says the Lord concerning the prophets who lead my people astray. That's exactly what we just met in Acts 13. You know, the people who cry peace when they have something to eat, but they declare war against them who put nothing in their mouth. Therefore, it shall be night to you without vision and darkness to you without divination. The sun shall go down on the prophets and the day shall be black over them. The seers shall be disgraced and the diviners put to shame. They shall all cover their lips, for there is no answer from God for them. But as for me, I am filled with power, with the Spirit of the Lord, and with justice and might. This is Micah now speaking on behalf of God. As for me, I'm filled with power, with the Spirit of the Lord, and with justice and might, to declare to Jacob his transgression and to Israel his sin. Hear this, you heads of the house of Jacob and rulers of the house of Israel, who detest justice and make crooked all that is straight. Again, exact language. Those who build Zion with blood and Jerusalem with iniquity, its heads give judgment for a bribe. Its priests teach for a price. Its prophets practice divination for money. Yet they lean on the Lord and say, "Is not the Lord in the midst of us? No disaster shall come upon us." Therefore, because of you, Zion shall be plowed as a field. Jerusalem shall become a heap of ruins, and the mountain of houses will be wood. Here again, what we see is God speaking what many would say is harshly, but it's God who loves his people that speaks the truth and tells them the truth all the time. Ezekiel 3, verses 4 through 11. And again, the same kind of message, the message that I pray you and I will become comfortable with. And he said to me, this is God speaking now, and he said to me, "Son of man, go to the house of Israel and speak with my words to them. For you are not sent to a people of foreign speech and a hard language, but to the house of Israel." I'm not sending you far away, I'm sending you to the church people. "Not too many people of foreign speech and hard language whose words you cannot understand. No, surely if I sent you to such people, they would listen to you. But," verse 7, "but the house of Israel will not be willing to listen to you." But the church folks, they won't listen to you. But the religious folks, they won't listen to you. "For they are not willing to listen to me." They won't listen to the word of God from the man of God because they won't listen to God himself. "But the house of Israel will not be willing to listen to you, for they are not willing to listen to me. Because all the house of Israel have a hard forehead and a stubborn heart." Behold, I love this. This is one of my personal passages. "Behold, I have made your face as hard as their faces, and your forehead as hard as their foreheads." I know that the Lord has given me a thick skull because I'm dealing with a lot of battering ram situations. He's literally given me thick skin because I'm going to need it. He did Ezekiel as well. "Behold, I have made your face as hard as their faces, and your forehead as hard as their foreheads. Like emery, harder than flint, I have made your forehead. Fear them not, nor be dismayed at their looks, for they are a rebellious house. Moreover," he said to me, "son of man, all my words that I shall speak to you, receive in your heart and hear with your ears. And go to the exiles, to your people, and speak to them and say to them, thus says the Lord your God, whether they hear you or refuse to hear from you." Again, direct instruction from the Lord to go. In Isaiah 49:2, Isaiah says, "The Lord himself has made my mouth to be like a sword." Again, whether you are using the machete of God's word to cut through that which would try to keep you out, or the Swiss Army knife of God's word that's designed to help you address and help others in any and all different circumstances, or if it's in the fine buck knife that's used to do the dressing and the skinning, if you will, to get ready for the scalpel that only the Spirit of God can wield to change a heart. This is who you and I have been called to be. Read Jeremiah 1 and 2 and see what God says to him about speaking the truth and the love that he's given him and to fear not. In fact, he says, if you're going to fear them, you better fear me. You go and speak what I have told you to speak and nothing else. Again, this is in our DNA, church. This is not for the pastor. This is not a single missionary encounter. You and I live in a war. When we say come and see, we're inviting people into a spiritual war. Now, we're guaranteed victory. The war has been won at the cross, but the battles rage on. I ask you, does this sound so foreign to you? Is there anybody here that cannot acknowledge that we are in a battle every single day? The battle with your flesh, the world around you, the devil himself. Are you prepared? The first encounter that we see in Acts tells us that we should be prepared, ready to deal with the devil and his minions while looking for those persons of peace, those in whom God is already doing a work. You see, he saves us out of our sin. He sends us out on mission. Then we have to do our part and set out in obedience and then spread out when we get to where he's called us to go. And in the spreading out, we speak out. That's what you see here. But we also shout out sometimes when you're up against a wolf. You've got to do what you've got to do. You see it here.